Hi, I'm Jeremy. I'm a drinking water analyst, and here today we're going to talk about drinking water sampling. Sampling for lead and copper in drinking water is very important for any community and is critical that all sampling is conducted properly to ensure accurate results. This method provides additional data to help pinpoint the source of any lead or copper in the resident's plumbing, including the faucet, the supply line, and the service line to the building. This method only works if the water is collected under certain conditions. You need to choose a kitchen or bathroom faucet that you use daily. Now is a good time to remove any faucet or sink mounted devices such as a water softener, filter, iron filter, or reverse osmosis system. Prior to collection, your water needs to sit in the pipes for at least 6 hours. Try setting a reminder to collect your sample first thing in the morning before everyone else in the house wakes up. You could also try to collect your sample after work if no one stays home during the day. This will ensure that no one took a bath, used the toilet, did dishes, or just used the water in general during that time. Once the waiting period is over, it's time to inventory what's in your box. Inside, you will find 5 bottles, some forms. There should also be a set of written instructions outlining the exact things we are showing in this video. The bottles should be labeled 1 through 5. Bottles 2, 3, and 4 will appear different. To prepare for sampling, first, remove the forms from the bottles and place them away from the sink so they don't get wet. Next, we'll remove the caps from the bottles, being careful not to touch the inside of the cap or the inside of the bottle. Now we're going to line up the bottles in order from 1 to 5. Make sure the bottles are next to the sink where it will be easy to reach them. Next, we're ready to sample. First, grab bottle 1 and place it directly under the faucet so it's ready to capture that first draw of water out of the tap. When you're ready, turn on the cold water tap. When filling the bottle, do not allow the neck to touch the faucet. As the bottle is filling, grab bottle 2 and hold it near bottle 1. When the water reaches the neck of bottle 1, immediately slide bottle 2 under the water stream. Do not turn the water off between sample bottles. Now you'll fill the water to the neck of bottle 2. Fill bottles 3 through 5 in the same manner, making sure we capture all the water coming from the faucet. Now, tightly twist the caps back onto bottles 1 and 5. Then pour the water out of bottles 2, 3, and 4 and allow them to dry. Are you collecting these samples for your local water supply? If so, check your paperwork to find out how to contact your water supply so they can pick up the sample. Now fill out the paperwork provided to you by the water supply or the lab. Don't forget to record the date, the time, your address, and name. If you're collecting these samples for your own purposes, it's your responsibility to make sure that the sample makes it to the lab within 14 days. Be sure to fill out the request for analysis form and include a form of payment before dropping the sample off or mailing it to the lab. For more information, call a number or visit the website on the screen. Thanks for watching, subscribe for more instructional videos, and happy sampling!